Chasm Workspaces offers an auto-scaling feature that can provision and destroy agents based on user demand. Agents serve as the compute resources responsible for storing workspace images and launching sessions when requested. Let's say you have 4 cores and 16 gigs of memory in total. Now, suppose a user starts a Chrome session that consumes 2 cores and 4 gigs of memory. If another user attempts to launch an Ubuntu Jammy session requiring 4 cores and 8 gigs of memory, Chasm won't have enough available resources to create that session. As a result, the session cannot be created on demand. This is where auto-scaling comes in. When auto-scaling is configured, as soon as Chasm detects that the compute resources drop below a defined threshold, Chasm automatically provisions new compute instances through your configured cloud provider, ensuring that enough resources are always readily available to accommodate new user requests for creating sessions. This also works the other way. If Chasm detects there are excessive compute resources than the defined threshold values, Chasm automatically destroys the excessive agents, thus saving your compute costs. Chasm supports auto-scaling for a variety of cloud providers like AWS, Azure, DigitalOcean, Oracle Cloud, Google Cloud, Harvester, KubeVirt, OpenStack, and vSphere. The upcoming release 1.17 will also support Proxmox and Nutanix. In this video, I'll explain the basic concepts and the different options that you can configure in order to use the auto-scaling feature in Chasm. First, let's talk a little bit about zones. Zones in Chasm allow you to create a logical grouping of Chasm services. Let's say your organization operates in multiple regions. You can group Chasm resources by region to optimize the performance for your users. For example, you can create one zone for US Ashburn and another zone for Asia Pacific, ensuring that users connect to the nearest resources. Zones can also be used to allocate resources to different departments within your organization. For example, you can create one zone for the marketing team and another zone for the engineering team. Refer to our documentation to learn how to configure and manage multiple zones in your Chasm deployment. If you're using a single server setup, Chasm comes with a default zone, which is named as default. You can edit the zone settings to configure various options. However, the most critical setting for auto-scaling to function properly is the upstream auth address. This address determines where connections to Chasm sessions are authenticated. It must be set to the IP or fully qualified domain name of the resource running the Chasm API service, as this is where authentication takes place. If you have a single server setup, this is set to proxy by default, which utilizes the local proxy for authentication. But when using the auto-scaling feature, the agents need to talk back to the upstream auth address, and the local proxy cannot be reached by the agents. So it is essential that you change this to the actual IP or FQDN of your server. Similarly, if you have a multi-server or a multi-region deployment, and if your Chasm API is sitting behind a load balancer, you need to set this correctly to the IP or fully qualified domain name of either your web app server or your load balancer if one is in place. Now let's talk about pools. Pools in Chasm can be used to group Docker agents or servers together for distributing and balancing workspace session requests. This may sound similar to zones, but it is not. There are two types of pools that you can create: Docker agent pool and server pool. A Docker agent pool contains Docker agents that store the workspace images and create sessions when requested. A server pool contains servers that the users can directly connect to, like Windows RDP, for example. Suppose you create a Docker agent pool in your zone. When a user requests to start a workspace session, the request gets forwarded to the Chasm web app. The web app then determines the most suitable agent in the pool to handle that session and forwards the request. You can configure different load balancer strategies for the Chasm web app, which is covered in our documentation. The link will be in the description below. Creating a pool in Chasm is simple. Simply navigate to your admin panel and then go to Infrastructure, Pools. Name your pool and select the pool type. When Chasm autoscales new resources, they are automatically assigned to the configured pool. Now that the pool is created, you can configure the autoscaling feature. Click on All Autoscale Configs and then click Add. Name the config and then choose the autoscale type. Make sure this matches with the pool type. Now select the pool where you want the autoscaled resources to be a part of. If you want Chasm to take more aggressive measures to provision raw compute resources, turn on aggressive scaling and then select the appropriate deployment zone. Next comes the standby settings. Here you can configure the standby compute resources that you want Chasm to keep readily available at all times. If the actual number of compute resources fall below this number, Chasm autoscales new agents. If the number of compute resources raise above this number, Chasm deprovisions or descales the excessive agents. Suppose you set the standby cores to 4 and the standby memory to 16 GB. Now, imagine you have a single available agent with 6 cores and 16 GB of memory. If a user starts an Ubuntu Jammy session that requires 4 cores and 8 gigs of memory, the remaining available resources drop to 2 cores and 8 gigs of memory, which falls below the configured standby values. As soon as Chasm detects this, it automatically provisions a new agent to maintain the standby compute resources. Downscale backoff is the amount of time Chasm will wait before it downscales your agents. Suppose the same user now terminates their Ubuntu Jammy session. The total available resources now rise up to 12 cores and 32 GB. And as you can tell, this is above the set standby values. So Chasm attempts to downscale the excessive agents to save you compute costs. Downscale backoff is the amount of time Chasm will wait before it attempts to downscale agents. This feature prevents compute resources from being downscaled too quickly. Next, we have the agent override settings. With these settings, you can override the actual number of cores and memory of your newly autoscaled agents. The values set here determine how Chasm interprets the resource capacity of the newly provisioned compute instances. For example, if you configured your agents to have 6 cores and 16 GB each, you can set the agent cores override to 4 cores and agent memory override to 12 gigs. And Chasm will only see these set values instead of the actual resource capacity. This enables you to make sure that Chasm doesn't utilize all the available resources on the agent. Instead, it only uses what's defined in the agent override settings. Ideally, these values should be set in such a way that they match with the actual number of cores and memory of the newly created agents, unless you have a different use case. Finally, you can configure the Nginx cert and key that you want Chasm to install on your agents. This is only required if you want to use a direct-to-agent workflow. You can generate a self-signed certificate and key and then paste them in these fields. Please note that these fields will be completely removed in our next release, 1.17.0. That covers all the essential configurations for setting up autoscaling in Chasm workspaces. When you click Next, you will be prompted to configure the VM provider-specific details. As I said, Chasm supports a variety of providers for autoscaling like OCI, Google Cloud, Azure, etc. In this video, I will not be covering the setup for each provider. But we have a dedicated playlist of provider-specific tutorials, which I'll link in the description below. Simply find the video that matches your chosen provider and follow along to complete your setup.